This is another real estate radio show with your host, Richard Womeldorf. Broadcasting from the Home Ownership Training Center in downtown McAllen, Texas, Richard offers educational podcasts for sellers, buyers, and investors of real estate.
Well, hello, everybody, and welcome to episode number 3 of the McAllen Real Estate Radio Show, broadcasting from downtown McAllen, Texas. My name is Richard Womeldorf. I am your host. Well, I'd like to welcome you. These podcasts are meant to be informative and educational. They're to help you overcome any fears that you might have in the home buying process. And today's subject is just part of one of my ebooks, The Richard's Guide to Buying Your First Home. And you can find that on my blog at richardwomeldorf.com. Just look over on the right-hand side and you'll see an ad graphic that'll point you to that ebook, which is Richard's Guide to Buying Your First Home. Today on episode 3, we're going to discuss a few items, and the very first step in, and we're going to discuss the very first step in any home buying process. And the second thing we're going to do is what to look out for when buying or looking at new homes, and also what to number 3, we're going to be talking about home sellers and why it may not be wise to be talking with home sellers without representation of your interests. And last, we're going to wrap up the show with a few informative websites and also a telephone number for more information. Now, in this episode, I want to address the very, very first step in your home buying adventure. And this is the most important step that any home buying plan should have. People looking to buy homes in McAllen or in any surrounding areas like Sherryland, Mission, Edinburgh, or Far should heed this warning. The very first thing that you should do is, before you shop for a new home, is to go get a copy of your credit report and credit score. And you can obtain a copy of your credit scores from any one or all three of these credit bureaus: Equifax, TransUnion, and Experian. And Equifax is EQUIFAX, and you can find them at EQUIFAX.com, Equifax.com. TransUnion, all one word, .com, TransUnion.com. And Experian.com is experian.com. You may consider ordering a 3-in-1 credit report to see what each credit bureau is reporting about you. Now, you're going to want to review your credit report for any potential problems that will need to be cleared up before you start shopping for your home. You don't want any surprises when you complete your home loan application. That's definitely not the point where you need to find out that you've got some credit problems. So it's real important to be proactive about getting your credit report first. Now, an additional note here, I think that most lenders nowadays will pull your credit report for free, but I have seen in the past where, depending on the lender that you go to, sometimes they may want to charge you to pull a credit report. Now, that's not a bad thing in itself, but you want to be proactive here, and having your own reports will save you that processing fee. Also, if you go from one lender to another, and you're out shopping for a week and you've got time and you're, you know, just shopping to see which lender fits your personality or what they've got, different products that they've got, you don't want your credit bureaus to be hit over and over and over again with them inquiring into your credit report. So I hope this isn't confusing, but it would be better if you go out when you're getting ready to go purchase a home, buy your own credit reports, make copies, and take those with you to the lenders so that they're not out there dinging on your credit on the credit bureau, which may hurt your credit score. And nowadays you want to protect that you want to really, really protect that and not let anything affect it. Okay, now after you've secured your credit report, The next big step for you to consider when preparing to purchase a home is to get pre-approved for your home loan. That's right, I'm talking about pre-approved for your home loan, not pre-qualified. And there is a big difference. You see, getting pre-approved for your home loan means that you have obtained approval for a certain amount for the home that you want to purchase. It also gives you an idea of your purchasing power, and then the lender will establish your debt-to-income ratios, and then they can give you an estimate of what your payments would be for a certain priced home. Now, this is a real good way to establish an upper and lower limit to the price points of the homes that you can look for in advance. This also helps find deals, also finds value, because if you're looking, let's just take a number, $100,000 to $125,000, and you're looking at three or four different homes, and you find one that gets into that bracket that has more square footage, is newer, is in better condition, it's really going to stick out as a better deal. And this is how you can find good houses that are at the best price when you're focused on a upper and lower limit. So basically, pre-approval means you already have your money for your home purchase, and you have the ability to negotiate a better deal with the seller because you have the funds to purchase quickly. So now that we have that, let's talk about how you look in the seller's eyes offering a price with a pre-qualified or pre-qualification letter. Now, a pre-qualification doesn't have too much clout because you have not secured approval for your home loan from a lender. But again, a lot of people, that's how they start out, is that they get pre-qualification letters and then they go through the process. I mean, this is basically normal. But the reason why I have the radio show and you're listening to this is to maybe get a tip or maybe get another idea or another view about the process. And the reason why I'm saying that you, if you can get a pre-approved, you're in a lot better shape, because let's just say that you find a real good house, and in the market today, if you found a good house and you know it's a good deal, other people are going to also know it's a good deal, and you may be in a bidding war with someone else. So let's put it where you go in and you're putting in an offer and somebody else is putting in an offer and the seller's got both offers in front of them. You, with a pre-qualified offer, would not be in the same position as maybe a pre-approved offer. So you could come in and say, look, I'm already pre-approved. I've already, basically have the loan ready to go. You just also, you also protect it now, because if you get the inspection, if you've got a real estate agent that's helping you, but if you've got if you have an inspection or there's any problems with the survey or any number of other things with the house, of course, you can back out of that depending on how the contract is worded, but you've got safety valves in place for that to happen also. But being pre-approved is a lot stronger than being pre-qualified. If you're listening to my podcast from outside the Rio Grande Valley, this pertains to you also. Back in episode 2, I gave you 7 reasons to get a buyer's agent working for you. A good buyer's agent will have a list of 3 to 5 mortgage lenders that they've close transactions with and they're happy with. These usually are professional lenders that know their stuff, and just like you and me, buyer's agents recognize pros and list those names and will offer those names to you because they want a smooth transaction and they want you, their client, to have a smooth transaction. Now, as you look for a home and you're looking for either a for sale by owner home or a used home, I'm going to harp again about getting a buyer's agent to represent you for that home purchase, because remember, when the seller starts to put his home on the market, he creates a listing agreement with an agent, and that agent then puts a sign out in front of the house, and the house is for sale. But if you're going to open houses and just calling on signs and you're dealing with the listing agent, that listing agent represents the seller. What that means is that whatever offers that you make with that agent and whatever you tell that agent, for the most part, must be relayed back to the seller. For example, if you tell that seller's agent that you could pay or had the ability to pay up to $200,000 for a particular property, but then thought, well, let's go ahead and put in a bid of $180,000, that agent usually has a duty to tell the seller that you could pay up to $200,000. You just put in an offer to begin with at $180,000. And this really would leave no room for you for further negotiation or the purchase of that house. So consider getting your own buyer's agent that will represent your interest for the home that you're trying to purchase. Consider getting a buyer's agent that will, get their commission is going to be a split from the listing agent. So in effect, you're getting representation for free. Now let's talk about buying a new home. And new homes are great. You go and you go to the models, you're looking around, everything's nice and new. But if you're buying a new home, usually the person inside the model homes are representing the builder. They're not representing you. In most cases, you will find that the terms of the contract or the purchase of the new home that is presented by the builder's agent is one-sided and may not protect your interest. I'm not saying that they're bad. I'm just saying usually they're a one-page contract, and many, many houses are sold that way. But the promulgated forms that we have in Texas, and I'm sure there's promulgated forms in different states, they're a little bit, they're a little bit more detailed, and they have offer a little bit more protection for the buyers and sellers within a purchase. But that doesn't mean that there's a problem. It just means that you should have a buyer's representative helping you to make sure that everything goes along okay. Again, builders work with real estate agents, and if you have a buyer's agent, that buyer's agent will be paid or compensated to bring you to the table. But then again, you're using the expertise of the buyer's agent to make sure that things go along smoothly and also give you tips about things that you may not think about that you should consider when you're buying the home. Buying a home is probably the most expensive purchase you'll make in your lifetime, and it's also one of the bigger investments for your future. So it's important that you do your research before you buy and take precautions that will make your home purchase easygoing, less stressful, and carefree. And we all want carefree. So go ahead and get started on your home purchase today, but go ahead and do that by working on your credit and your credit scores and getting that in order. So that's it for episode number 3. This is Richard Womeldorf, your host. I am an agent for HCH Realty, and Ken Desjarnet is the broker. My podcasts are being broadcast from our 10,000 square foot building in downtown McAllen. And inside, we have a 1,300 square foot home ownership training center where we hold monthly seminars to help new and experienced buyers of real estate in the Metroplex area of McAllen, Texas. I also have a hotline that's 956-683-6062. That is our show hotline. That number again is 683-6062. Now this is a robot phone line. No one's there to answer it. You can go ahead and call that and leave your message. If you have questions and you would like myself or my staff to give you a call, just leave a message there and we'll get back to you. And also, if you have some ideas about future podcasts or some subjects for some episodes, also leave those there. We would appreciate that. Again, this is Richard Womeldorf. I appreciate it. We have information for sellers, buyers, and for sale by owners. So until next time, this is Richard Womeldorf, your host, where our motto is empowering lives with affordable homes, where we have information for sellers, buyers, and for sale by owners, so that you can use that information to empower your life so that you can find that affordable home for yourself. Thank you very much. Talk to you next time.